Welcome back. We're halfway through fighting a dog. Please. I needn't die. Varn is really coming into his own as the healer right now. Oh, you've got the wind on your side, have you now? Glad to see you're doing another one of these immediately, I feel like. It's only been a few, like not even a full minute in-game since you did that. Previously, of course, in the reality, I went off and got food. Fucking pissed into the eye of the storm just to see what would happen. Did all sorts of, like, just fucking took care of myself to make the rest of this bearable. Slapped a dog. Rather than leaving the area, I just had it paused. So we still haven't left the area yet. And I don't know where the thing is that tracks that fact, but it will say that we have done it in one continuous attempt so far. I have not needed to redact my eyes so far. I'm hoping that will continue to be the case. This is the scenario, and I don't have this luxury right now because I'm doing a video, but I would kind of zone out and put like an ASMR video on or something, just to be like, you know, something I don't have to pay too much attention to by design, because it's like meant to not prevent you from sleeping. It is exactly the correct amount of stimulation, which makes it very good for situations like that where you want something on, but not like a thing. You don't want it to be a thing. Unfortunately, it has the side effect of rendering me incredibly sleepy during whatever it was I was trying to do. So, you know, it gives and it takes. It takes all its noses. It puts a flute up to your elbow and says, "Sniff that." Which is just wrong on so many levels. Like, you don't... There's no point sniffing a flute, and you wouldn't do it with your elbow. I think the person who did this might be an alien. If I had to guess. Or an AI. One of the two. Either way, clearly doesn't understand humanity at all, really. Ash, don't... I'm like... You're so much not the healer right now that I've even forgotten that I've set those gambits up for you and haven't turned them off, which I should probably turn them off. I think, like, if I'm gonna keep complaining about it. But I do... It is helping us so much that you are downstairs. You are doing such a good job of being down the stairs, it is legitimately kind of carrying the attempt. If I had to keep bringing you back over and over again... Like, we have Fran out now as sort of a contingency for that kind of thing. And that's helpful because she knows Ray's specific... I should specify because that's why it's handy. I think it's time for another Zodiac summoning. To give me chance to regain my MP. We've really entered a sort of rhythm with this. Where I do... Oh, fuck, you're gonna take 300 years to properly clean the toilet now, aren't you? For those of you who weren't here last time, and, like, it's so weird of you to start on episode 88, but, like, to each his own. For some reason... Alright, I'll tell you about the reason later on. Like, if you have actions in a queue, like if you're executing an action and I, in the middle of you doing that, tell you to start doing something else, the queue icon appears next to it, and it does take slightly longer. Zodiac in exchange for, like, actions happening immediately, like, the moment he readies them, I guess. I mean, like, I'll show you. Oh, that, it actually didn't take that long at all that time. But, like, for some reason, like, right when I needed to be quick, the queued action renew takes 3 million hours to sort of load into existence. And it's turned into a real liability at the moment. Like, instant deployment, very slow Josephs. We're carrying out the entire nativity in slow motion right now. So I've connected. It's another potential connection between the nativity and Dio Brando here. I did a bit in another video about Dio Brando's nativity career. And I think he may be slowing down the nativity himself. I mean, he stops time, he doesn't, like, slow it down, technically. So maybe this is somebody else's doing, but, like, someone else with time powers is interfering with the nativity. Maybe all the actors are just extremely slow, is the other possibility. It could be the human snail. It could be the human snail's Christmas extravaganza. I haven't checked. I probably should have taken a look at the programming. But, you know, that's on me. You can all... You know what? Find someone else to tell you about snails. I'm fucking sick of it. I have better things to do. I've got to punch this dragon in the ass for 5 more hours. Oh, I think it's a shame that you look like a T-Rex. I'm surviving. You've not done that thing that just seems to immediately kill Zodiac the moment I stop paying attention. So, like, whatever the fuck was going on there, it doesn't appear to be going on here. Well, having said that, you seem to be getting new trousers. Oh, you're gonna scare me with a stick. You're gonna scare the birds away like this. Oh! I mean, if I were a bird, I'd avoid that. That's like you're interfering with the thing that lets me float around. The power of the air. And you've turned it into a big funny circle motion, and I'm scared by that. So why would I not leave? What's compelling a bird to stick around at that point? Time. What do you have under time? Very fast ideas. Anyway, I got distracted. Let's... Total eclipse of the guy! What you've forced me to do there is to think about the crow. The new one. I went to see it. And I don't know. It's like, it's a film about the crow. You know, I mean, I enjoyed myself. I think it was mostly just the fact that I was going out seeing a movie. I think most movies would have done. But it's fun enough for what it is. I saw a review of it that called it, like, unbelievably awful or like, incomprehensibly bad or something of that effect. And that seems harsh. It seems calculated. The Crow, I think, is a movie that was doomed to be mocked no matter what. Like, no matter its quality. Oh, there's new stairs over here. Hang on. Let me go down these stairs. Let me go down these stairs! A new flight of stairs for a new generation of warriors. Speaking of which, actually, I've been having morbid thoughts recently. By which I, of course, mean I have been thinking about the Morbius movie. Because, like... You know, it flopped horrendously. And then the internet memed it so hard the execs thought that they could, like, release it a second time and it would definitely make money this time. And then it flopped again. And it's the funniest thing the internet's ever done. greatest prank in the history of humankind. So, like, that's all established history now. We've had our fun, that's behind us. Like, what was that movie like, though? Aren't you a little curious? I'm a little curious. I wouldn't watch it alone. Heaven forbid. I don't expect that I could get through it without inflicting it on someone else. I need there to be someone in the trenches with me mucking it together. Like, it's a two-person job. It's a two-person job, it feels like. I want to be like, but what if it's actually a really good film? But I don't think that's in the cards. But then again, I am the kind of person who watched the new Crow movie and was like, this is actually not that bad. So, who knows? Maybe Morbius would have been fine for me, for my purposes. Personally, I think it's the fact that it's the Crow and not a Marvel thing probably helped. Like, I think if the same movie were part of the Marvel Cinematic Universe, I'd probably be more... I mean, I wouldn't have watched it. Like, I'm at the point where I sort of, like, don't watch them. Not, like, exclusively just on principle, but also, like, it's just exhausting to keep up with. Like, if I watch this movie... I can't have watched this movie without having seen about six previous ones that are going to be, like... The events of them or the ramifications of them are going to be, like, brought up constantly, and it's going to, like... All the movies just exist to advertise each other at this point. Too much investment. Too much investment is needed of time, of brain space, and of money, let's be honest, because it ain't cheap. It ain't cheap to seize films. Seize the films! I have to buy catapults, siege ramps, also like battering rams, to break down the front gates of the bloody warehouse where all of the old-timey film reels are kept. How much health are you? Enough. Enough! I don't want to be in the summon menu. I want to be out here sneezing on a bone. Like anyone. Oh, God. The thing about films like The Crow is, and it's something that Elodie has said on an episode of Things Talk, and it's really sort of stuck with me. This was in reference to Star Wars, she said this, for context. You have to go into it knowing that it's shit. It's The Crow. Like, the man's in his bloody goth makeup, looking like birds, and being like, I'm gonna do a revenge. Like, how do you not know what you're in for going into that? Like, it's not subtle about it. Yes, it's gonna be cringe-inducingly edgy. Like, how... You have to accept that as the joke. Could you not stop me from achieving my destiny, please? Have one of your bloody noses on. A false nose for me to do. You've summoned cum. Please stop. No, don't you go down the stairs. You're gonna cause problems. You're gonna cause problems with that sort of attitude. All of our stair going is gonna be diddly dastard, isn't it? Because of you. Speaking of movies that are in the same cinematic universe as Morbius, because they were trying to make a cinematic universe off the back of that, let's not forget. And then it failed miserably, so they just sort of threw their lot in with the existing cinematic universe at the first opportunity they got. Third Venom movie's coming out. Third Venom movie's coming out. I'm actually really excited for that. Let There Be Carnage is a really good film, actually. And I've said this before, and I will say it again. It was a good movie. I genuinely think they were slumming it by introducing themselves in a bloody MCU canon. I think that Let There Be Carnage is a better movie than a lot of stuff that the MCU churns out, and there's more love in it than a lot of the MCU churns out. And I want to see what the third one does about us. And the tagline is "Till death do us part," and they are fully aware that these are gay married funny boys. It's just, it's Venom, you know, and they're leaning into the exact parts of it that I want them to lean into. And just, it's very good. It's very good, and I love the
little goopy guy. Please stop murdering the sorcerer, though.
I won't excuse that just because the third Venom movie's coming out. There's also Beetlejuice Beetlejuice, which is one of those things where I'm not entirely sure this needed a sequel, but I am still probably gonna watch it. It's like one of those where it's like, I'm not sure what I'm gonna make of this, but it's... I don't know. I think like I have enough fondness for the original to where I'm kind of like, I'll see what this is like. Although, mind you, had I made that mistake with Space Jam, I don't know what might have become of me, so maybe I should be a bit more careful about that sort of response. Hold on, something shat. We managed to get through quite a lot of that without any technical difficulties, and now all of a sudden, it's done a thing again.
Nobody knows I'm a trouble.
Do you want to run up here and just quickly? Because regen doesn't... Oh, you're about to bloody die anyway now. Will this matter? Nope, it won't. Good stuff. Do things! And then heal me for it, thank you. Return of the truth. And then... Are you able to... Not quite. Oh dear. Oh, but you can now, though. And I will expose you as a fraud. Or I won't. Oh, don't target the one. No! 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 I forgot to, like, do that at any point as well. Aha! You fool, you've sort of played into my hands. Now it's time for more of this. Another summoning must take place to distort the prospective human face. This is what we think the new human face should be. Or what someone does, anyway. It's like, I don't know. I don't know about it. I feel like we've had a human face that is well established at this point. I think if we go changing it now, we're just gonna render everyone uncanny. It's gonna be impossible for people to talk to each other anymore because they're all thinking, is this what we're really going with for the new face? Because, like, it has to be different enough to where people aren't questioning why we bothered. You know what I mean? I won't bother exposing you again. But, like, the more different we make it, the more difficult it's going to be to adjust to. And then people are going to end up asking why we bothered doing it anyway, because, like, look what the result was. You can't win when you change people's faces around. I wish they'd pointed that out to Nick Cage before he killed John Travolta. In real life. Or, like, technically the other way around, I guess, because that we're wearing each other's face. I don't know. This is exactly the kind of thing we want to avoid by not removing your face in the future.
I would like to go back in time and put your face back on properly.
if it's not too much fucking trouble. You're neat. You've done the thing again where you just one of your attacks just suddenly, instantly kills me. Oh wow, you did not particularly recover much health either. Oh yeah, good, instant kill move. Nice instant kill move, mate. I can't wait for you to do it again in 3 seconds. Down the stairs. Sneaking off downstairs to have another pie! Yeah. I told you. What did I tell you? That's going to be his new hobby. It's going to be his new hobby for the remainder of the fight. Jesus! You keep loving to swipe. You keep loving to swipe at Fran, but I'm afraid I don't allow that. Stop slapping me! You're becoming extremely slappy right now, and you're doing death upon all of it again. It almost feels too late to circle back to this thought now, but the thing that annoys me about Space Jam 2, conceptually, is that it's doing a thing, like, it's inside, it takes place inside Warner Brothers servers, right? So, it's like, they have this opportunity to bring out every property that they own. So all the characters from various different places, various different continuities are all, and it's like a more mask-off version of the problem that I have with, like, everyone doing multiverse stuff at the moment. Like, because this, when, for example, all of the Spider-Men, well, 3 of the Spider-Men happened at once. Like the MCU Spider-Man film with all of Sam Raimi and Andrew Garfield. It's weird that in the case of the Sam Raimi films I name the director, but like in the case of the Andrew Garfield one I name Andrew Garfield. Maybe he directed them, I don't know. Clearly I wasn't paying attention. Shall we be kind and attribute the Garfield ones to Alan Smithy? I mean, like, even, like, it's... Nah, they were bad. I'm not gonna, like, I enjoyed watching the bloody Electro one, but again, that's because I was fully aware, as I did so, that I was watching trash. It felt like an example of what I would call a lot of people making the best of a bad film that they were in. Which is sometimes more enjoyable to watch than an actually good movie, in my opinion, but maybe that's just me. I've lost track completely of my original point. Right, yeah, because they put all the Spider-Men together in the MCU film, and it felt like they were just saying, hey, remember those older, beloved Spider-Man films? They're ours now. Spider-Man is ours forever, even the ones we didn't do, so eat shit and die crying. And then you have Space Jam 2, where it literally is that. It's just like, look at all the things we own. And it's just a little bit of a shame to have to witness. I don't know. I don't know. Forgive me for being cynical, but I'm not going to apologise for it, so you'll have to forgive me baselessly. Woo. So I was just yelling at the machine to make sure it was still breathing. A bit very nervous when I look at the device and it's not giving me sound waves. Even if the cause of that is simply that I haven't been speaking for a minute. Chuck an elixir on us, no problem. It's no problem, Dan.
Look, everybody, it's no problem, Dan. He shows up when everything's fine.
Where was he in our moment of crisis? Was not our place to ask, fucking apparently. Fucking Dan. Daniel Fairweather. I mean, the writing was on the wall from the moment of his birth, wasn't it? With a name like Daniel. Do 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 do. Can you see if you can guess at what point in that I forgot how the tune went? You think the fact that I'm hearing it right now might have assisted me in remembering, but no. It's actually not useful information in the slightest. Oh, well, you've condemned me to death. Oh, Bash has been dead this whole fucking time. Q-Ill. I'm gonna bring some people back to life, and 1, 2, 3, I've got a knife. Is everyone able to become fast? Well, everyone else was. That's fine. That's fine, as long as we have quick fastness, the world's gonna be made of gravy. No, don't undo anything that isn't already on the people who are there! Trapping me on the fucking stairs now. It's too terrible. Don't... Oh, you've made it impossible. It's fine. It's fine, just bring her back. We'll do the rest tomorrow! You are taking some fucking liberties, I'll tell you what. I can lower your magic power. I don't have the equivalent that just lowers your attack, it doesn't look like. Is that the one technique I'm missing? Because that'd be a hell of a thing. I think it's a little bit bitch of you to have an insta-kill move that you spam. It feels a little bit spammy, but maybe that's just because it's an insta-kill move. But, like, you're really not... You're really giving it a good old larf, aren't you? It's just because then I have to reapply a bunch of status effects to the people who are coming back to life, and it's just... It's annoying, you know? You've annoyed me with your claws. Every week you do this, don't you? You're annoying me with your claws again. I keep warning you about this. I keep yelling at you from behind the big styrofoam frog. The most intimidating position to yell from. Scientifically. If you don't listen to this, there's no hope for you. You just have no sense of self-preservation at that point. Is it me, or has he completely stopped using his insta-kill move? Fair enough. This is a dragon that listens to feedback. Nice to see, honestly. For a moment, I was a bit concerned that the dragon was wrong. I was like, they need to invent a version of you that's not trying to kill me so we can all enjoy it, you know what I'm saying? And you did. You're standing on the camera, man. Down here, you can't blow the wind at me. It won't touch my nose. I won't even sneeze at the breeze, will I? Come off with you. Oh, I did anyway. I couldn't quite stop it from taking place. That's a shame. Come on, everyone, be alive. And get that away from you. While you go down the stairs, yet again, because of course this is your job. I'm like wary of his doing the big instant blast again, but he seems to have gone off the idea. He seems to have gone off the idea of doing it. So why don't we have a little bit of a go? Oh, you're trying it on him, and it works on him. Okay. I'd have done it on Van and gotten rid of the both of us, but maybe I'm not smart for telling you that. course, what this does mean is that you've not had an opportunity to regain. I've got 11 elixirs, why not use them? I'm being a bit silly, frankly. I'm being Frank Ocean. Help me, I'm being Frank Ocean! Then everybody runs towards you because they think, oh no, he's gonna steal a casino. And then, so I was just trying to remember the plot for a second there. And then they're all looking at you thinking you're gonna steal the big casino all the time because your wife was sad or whatever. And then, it turns out you weren't going to, and they miss the person doing the actual crimes. That's one of the confidence tricks with funny names that they don't explain what it means. It's called an arduous Susan, and we're not going to tell you why or what steps are involved because we are giving you the impression that we are seasoned people who don't need to explain this to each other anymore, and we've almost certainly made these names up regardless. We've gotten rid of quite a lot of your health bar, haven't we? Sort of mirrors how I feel about this playthrough in general. Like, it is baffling to me that we are actually this close to the end of the game. It has been such an extensive project. It has been a very long moment in the moment machine. But we're here, and the dragon's almost dead. Is this technically a type of dragon, or is like a worm technically a different thing? And I've been making a fool of myself to all of the bloody dragon biologists this whole time. He was trying to force us all down the stairs so that we can target everybody we love. You're gonna go over there and do it. And not be close enough when it happens. That's fine, you can heal Varn. That'll be perfectly acceptable. Everything's going to go exactly according to my plan. From here on out. 7 hits, eh? You've got your gloves on something fierce, haven't you? I'm bringing out the fierce hand, he says. You don't even really have hands. I mean, you have more hands than you'd think. Because you've got weird fingers like that instead of actual feet that you should have. So it's probably fine to have said all this. Isn't it so silly that we've been doing the same fight for the entire video? Isn't that so quirky of us? I'm trying to think, like, it would have been PS2, so like Twitch would not have been a thing really, would it? Like, we were nowhere near the era of like, oh, I'm gonna stream myself blowing up the entire Eiffel Tower. Let's try summoning Percy once again. See if he can kiss a solution into the ether. Yeah, that's all fine, and then I'm going to need you to help us to be alive still. Or you can die instantly. That's also an option. I would hate for anyone to think I was inflexible. You know what? If you wanna perish, just straight into the soup. Off you go. Don't let me keep you. Does he maybe wait for a certain status effect to be on one of us before he does Death Strike? Which I've just realised is an X-Men character as well. So, rude of you to turn the X-Men against me. I mean, not the X-Men, like, but someone who knew them. I would like you, if you can, to explode slightly faster. I don't want this running into another episode, because I have worked out that I can get this. I can probably get this series to be exactly 90 episodes long. There is definitely not enough content left to reach 100. But I could hit a nice round 90. So, if you'll stop blinding me with your neck hoop, or your nose hoop, actually, because I keep realizing that that's not your face. The bit that juts out of the hoop is not your face like I keep thinking it is. Whack a bit of faith on my friends. And then I'm gonna do this again. I'm gonna heal everyone at once. And then I'm gonna run away.
Let me run away, please, a bit more than that.
There we go, there's all the thousands and thousands of pounds. I'm investing in you so much you fucking died. You've got coin poisoning, I'm sorry to say, it's terminal. We know of no cure for it. I'm gonna be honest, I wasn't aware that this was a thing that could happen to a person. There's been no research into how poisonous the coins are because why would we? It's absurd that this has happened. I'm sorry it had to be to you. Oh, to me! Oh, your level's doubled now. Because what you desperately needed was another advantage. It's starting to look as though I might need to consider running away and touching a stone and coming back. I'm honestly not sure the extent of the advantage it would give me at this point. But just like, he's just a lot right now. He's extremely a lot. You've done him again. He's just like one attack out of every 20 just fucks you through the floor. Just having to keep myself near the stairs now for multiple reasons, because it's gonna... I'm gonna need to run away. I'm gonna need to leg it. I'm going to need to fucking toddle off at quite a pace. Oh, cheers. Cheers, Cungus. He's the national Cungus as well, so he does this all over the country. Oh, wind. Wind goings. Alright. It is gonna be a case of touch the soup. I need to go and stop touching everything that's not the soup for a moment. Yeah, just grab me on the way out. Bop me on the snonkus. We had a good run. We had a good run, but there's just too many of us fucked at once, and I'm not going to be able to recover in the moment. Alright, what's the damage? How much did he recover? I can't tell if he recovered anything, to be quite honest. Oh, you're doing stuff to yourself. You're doing all sorts. Oh, I can't have that. Oh, I'm sorry, sir, but you don't get to have those on you. Alright, that's the other thing. They've all come back. Oh, you had to instantly put your level back up, as if the sneeze never happened. Reinforcing that you're stage 2, look. It says on the screen that it's stage 2. I guess that's what we mean when we say it's stage 2. A rather literal interpretation, but one that I'm happy with. I'm gonna actually try summoning Zodiac now. Because I want to see how much damage something else does, and it just makes sense to get Big Betsy summons off of his crumbs at once! Good lord! That was a little bit nerve-wracking. It was a little bit nerve-wracking, but we've just about managed to get past it. Of course, we might not get past this, because it's the wind. Avoiding the wind's a bit like avoiding a trench coat. You can only do it if there's a trench coat nearby. Oh god. Please help me to not die. Oh, you fucking perished.
Right, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna blow you up with the machine.
And then that'll be that. Well, that's all of my mischarges gone at once. Let's hope we get some good shuffles then, because otherwise I may have just... I mean, like, the mischarge... Now that it doesn't use up MP, the mischarges are just sat there not doing anything for most of you. So... Oh, yes! That's exactly the kind of luck we need right now if we're going to defeat... Mr. James. Mr. James, the biggest donkey in the fucking universe. The hope is that it'll do enough damage at least to offset any HP regained by me leaving and coming back in. Like, I will settle for an incremental war of attrition-style bonking of the seventh seal. At this point, if it means the job gets done at all. The dreaded lino beast shoots his orbs. 17 hits is one of the longest chains we have had. I'm sort of bracing myself for the amount of damage to be a little bit pathetic, but it's okay. It's okay, it's still damage, and it's damage done from complete safety as well. It's damage done without needing to pull my mechanical trousers out of the ditch. Oh, and I'm okay and I'm fine. You nearly died. You should go home. And out of gold needles. I've only been using the gold needles to save Ash from having to come out of the ground. We're using mole tactics right now, and it's working out for us, and I don't want to jeopardize the mission. But my god, I actually did not take stock at all of how much damage the quickening chain did, which is potentially very silly of me, because, like... What if I need to do it again? And it turns out that would actually be very useful of us. We are now at the point in proceedings where there are actively other things I was hoping to do today that I may not get the opportunity to if this does not wrap up soon. So, if the man would like to die, then I shall be in the sky. Because I'll jump for joy so much that it'll be like, oh, bloody hell, that's brilliant. That's a brilliant idea. Why didn't I jump like that back in 1864 when it would have saved thousands of lives? And then whoever this character is who's talking right now will sort of experience that moment of regret. As I am brought back to life. I actually might need... No, hang on. Hang on. Well, it meant nothing in the end. Another cyclone. For how long we have to spend fighting him? I mean, like, I'm not saying I want the... Curious. Tremendously curious. I actually think you're better off just bringing back the dead, to be quite honest. Well, this is an issue, and I'm gonna run away about it. You've done another thing where we're all, when I think about how long I would have had to have spent redoing all that, it makes me proud to be British. Thinking about it, that's actually an extremely good point. I'm gonna go ahead and save the game. Does this now have to take three parts? Is that what we're learning? I don't want it to, but at the very least I may need to stop and, like... I'll go in for one more dip. I'll dip in the fucking chalice one final time, just to get on with it. Right, I don't want you having it at all. Maximum goings for maximum stoppings. That's my new motto. He's learned to wander away from the stairs. No. No, I need you to be unstopped. You specifically need to be unstopped more than most people. Oh look, we're going near these. Look how much near the stairs we are. Come over here. You really ought to.
Didn't bother coming over the stairs. He's just rudely attacking the gods.
As much as it would be nice to get this finished, this episode,
I'm developing a headache, and I'd like to go and to get some fresh air. So that is probably what I am going to do. As soon as it becomes apparent that I need to flee for my life again. In fact, I may stop recording here on the understanding that that is likely to be the case in the immediate future. And just we could cut back when... Because it's just going to be more of me surviving this. I think we've seen all the tricks the boy's going to pull out. And they are quite nasty. So, is anybody going to be particularly aggrieved if I tell you you can leave it to your imagination? Is anybody going to kill Van again?
Raised from the dead. Turned into fish. 7 fish at least.
Yeah, I'm out of words. I'm officially out of words, bones, everything's. So you can tune in next to... Just instantly make it redundant, why don't you? You're illegal. Fuck this for the time being. I'm going out to breathe for a bit. Goodbye!